him, ask for his help, seek his forgiveness, and we seek refuge in him from the evils of ourselves, and we seek refuge in him from the evils of our misdeeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whoever Allah misguides, none can guide. And I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon his prophet Muhammad, his companions, his followers, and those who followed his path till the day of judgment. My dear brothers and sisters, I advise you and myself to have piety of Allah, as he ordered us in the Quran, saying, O you have believed, have piety of Allah as you should have it, and don't die except you are Muslims. Today, inshallah, I'm gonna speak about an important matter. That is the purpose for which Allah created us, the worship of Allah. As we all know, Allah is the one who created all people and ordered them to worship him. As he said in the Quran in the chapter of Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O people, worship your Lord who created you and those before you so that you may become pious. So Allah is the one who created us and ordered us to worship him. If I ask it any one of you, why Allah did create you, I think everyone has a different answer in his mind. Did Allah create you to eat and drink and sleep and go to work and do as many people do? And do as many people do every day? Of course, the answer is no. Allah has created for a purpose bigger than that. Allah has created you to worship him. As he said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have only created mankind and the jinn to worship me. Subhanallah, when we look to people, we find that people are busy and are preoccupied with the worldly matter, with worldly matters. They are preoccupied with their children, with their business. And the life around us and the society around us takes us away from everything related to religion. Takes us away from worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. And in addition to that, we find many Muslims who are negatively influenced by the customs and the traditions of the society, even if these traditions contradict with the teachings of Islam. And this is the reason why we find many Muslims without Islam. They are only Muslims by their tongue, but they don't fulfill the rights of Allah over them. They don't pray, they don't be zakah, they don't pay attention to anything. They only come to the mosque in Ramadan, fast Ramadan, and that's it. Subhanallah, the purpose for which Allah created you is bigger than that, is to worship him. But people are busy. People are preoccupied. People are far away from everything that is related to religion. The worship of Allah is the right over us. The right of Allah over us. We have to worship him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us in the hadith, which was narrated by Muaz, when he was riding behind the Prophet on a mount, on a donkey called Ghufayr. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Ya Muaz, atadri ma haqqu Allahi ala al-ibad wa ma haqqu al-ibadi ala Allah? Qala Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. Qultu wala ya rasul Allah, Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. قال فإن حق الله على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا وحق العباد على الله أن لا يعذب من لا يشرك به شيئا فقلت يا رسول الله أفلا أبشر الناس قال فلا تبشرهم فيتكلوا. So Muaz was riding behind the Prophet on a donkey called Ghufayr. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked him, O Muaz, do you know what is the right of Allah over his servants, over people? And do you know what is the right of the servant is over Allah? He said, O Messenger of Allah, Allah and His Messenger know best. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَأَمَّا حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ, the worship of Allah over His servant is over people is to worship Him and don't associate anything with Him. وَأَمَّا حَقُّ الْعِبَادِ عَلَى اللَّهِ, and the right of the servant is over Allah is that He will not punish anyone who doesn't associate anything with Him. So Muaz became very happy with this answer and said, O Messenger of Allah, can I tell people? Shall I tell people, inform people? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تخبرهم فتتكلوا. Don't inform them, don't tell them, so that they rely on that. They don't worship Allah Azza wa Jal. So we have to worship Allah. This is a right over us. May I ask a question? What is the purpose of worshiping Allah? The purpose of worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal is that by worshiping Him, Allah distinguishes between those who obey His commands and those who don't obey them. So that He may reward those who obey Him with Jannah, with paradise, and punish those who don't obey Him with hellfire. This is a kind of justice. And to give you an example, let me give you an example to make it clear for you. If you have two sons or two boys, and one of them obeys your order and carries out what you order him, while the other does the opposite and doesn't obey any of your orders, would these two boys be equal in your sight? Would you treat them the same way? Of course, the answer is no. The one who obeys your orders and carries out what you order him to do will be more beloved to your heart. And this is a kind of justice. And this is what we mean by that. The one who worships Allah and obeys Him is not equal to the one who doesn't obey Allah and doesn't worship Him. Allah Himself is not in need of our worship, as worship doesn't benefit Him and doesn't harm Him. But Allah Azza wa Jalla ordered us to worship Him to distinguish between those who obey His orders and those who don't obey His orders. But we are the ones who are in need of worshiping Allah to get the reward and the recompense He promised us to get upon worshiping Him. As He said, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَعَلَيْهَا وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. Whoever does righteousness, it is for his own soul. And whoever does evil, it is against his soul. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. And your Lord is never unjust to His servants. And as He informed us in the secret hadith, which was narrated by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah said in the secret hadith, يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّكُمْ لَن تَبْلُغُوا ضُرِّي فَتَضُرُّونِي. And this is a small part of the hadith because it is long hadith. يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّكُمْ لَن تَبْلُغُوا ضُرِّي فَتَضُرُّونِي وَلَن تَبْلُغُوا نَفْعِي فَتَنْفَعُونِي. يَا عِبَادِي لَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ وَآخِرَكُمْ وَإِنسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ كَانُوا عَلَى أَتْقَى قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا ولو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجر قلب رجل واحد ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. So in this hadith, in this part, Allah said, O my servants, you will not attain harm in me so as to harm me, and you will not attain benefit in me so as to benefit me. يا عبادي, O my servants, if the first of you and the last of you and the jinn of you and the mankind of you, we're all as the one who has the most pious heart of you, this would not increase my kingdom and Adam. And the opposite thing, if the first of you and the last of you, the mankind of you and the jinns of you, we're all as wicked as the most wicked heart of any person amongst you, this would not increase my kingdom and Adam. Nothing. So the worship doesn't benefit Allah or harm Him. But we are the ones who benefit from worshiping Allah. Someone may ask another question. If worship doesn't benefit Allah or harm Him, so why Allah made it obligatory upon us? Why Allah made it obligatory upon us to worship Him? As I told you, to distinguish between his servants, between who carries out his orders and who obey his commands, and those who don't obey his commands. And one of the main objectives of the ibadah, of the worship, is that ibadah help us to get good morals, good manner, good manner and ethics, because the Muslim who worship Allah and who do all acts of worship like zakah and like siyam and other acts of worship doesn't do anything haram, doesn't cheat, doesn't lie, doesn't commit anything haram. And if he did something like that, he quickly comes back to Allah and regret for everything he did. And also the worship of Allah is like the food for the soul. This is the food of your soul. As we know, in a human being consists of a body and soul. So the nourishment of the body is food and drink. The body cannot do without food and drink. And also the soul cannot do without worshiping Allah. And subhanAllah, anyone who abandoned the worship of Allah and doesn't obey him, what happens to him? So he turns into a materialistic and selfish person who lives in this dunya, in this life, to fulfill his desire and commit everything that is haram without paying attention for anything or holding himself accountable for anything, because he doesn't worship Allah. Because worshiping Allah all times reminds you that you Allah watches you, Allah sees you, so you don't commit anything haram. You are in a continuous contact with Allah. You know that you put it in your consideration that Allah is watching you and Allah sees you. So you do everything that makes you get nearer to Allah. Do everything that is halal. And the Muslim is supposed to worship Allah under all circumstances and conditions, all time. This is how was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? We don't know when death will approach us, when we will die and leave this dunya. So we have to worship Allah at all times and under all conditions, so that if death approaches us, so we die while worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite his high status and rank, he used to worship Allah under all circumstances and conditions at all times. As Aisha narrated about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he used to pray during the night until his feet become swollen. So Aisha asked him, لِمَا كُلُّ هَذَا وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأْخَرَ. Oh Prophet, why all this worship? And Allah has forgiven your past and future sins. So he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not be a grateful servant? He used to remember Allah all times. Always, all time, his tongue was busy with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. He used to fast many days. So this is how was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is how the Muslim should be. And that is why he advised Umran ibn Husayn, saying, صَلِّ قَائِمًا فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَقَاعِدًا فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَعَلَى جَنْبِكِ. He advised Umran ibn Husayn to worship Allah under all circumstances and conditions. He said, oh Umran, pray while standing. If you cannot, pray while sitting. If you cannot, pray while lying in your side. But he didn't give him excuse to leave the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. So as I told you, we have to worship Allah under all circumstances and conditions. Ibadallah, istaghfirullah, yaghfir lakum. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. الشهيد رضي الله عنه في كفاسيس بيأبو إسبروك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. We have to worship Allah. And as I told you, worshiping Allah is a cause for admitting to Jannah, inshallah. But we shouldn't become arrogant by worship or have pride over others, or put in our consideration that it is obligatory upon Allah to admit us to Jannah by our worship. No, nothing. Nothing is obligatory upon Allah. And worship alone is not enough to be admitted to Jannah, but it is only by the mercy of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدٌ الْجَنَّةَ بِعَمَلِهِ قَالُوا وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ قال ولا أنا إلا أن يتغمدني الله برحمته. So he said صلى الله عليه وسلم none shall enter paradise by his deeds. So they asked him, not even you, O Messenger of Allah. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم not even me. And we know the story of the man who worshipped Allah for 500 years in a mountain. And then he passed away while making sujood, prostrating for Allah. So after he passed away, Allah resurrected him and asked the angels to admit him to Jannah, to paradise. He said, Allah said to the angels, admit him to paradise by my mercy. So the servant said, admit me to paradise by my deeds. Allah said it again, admit my servant into Jannah by my mercy. And he said, by my deeds. So Allah Azza wa Jalla asked the angels to weigh the blessing of sight against his deeds. So this is what already happened, and the all of his deeds was not equal to the blessing of sight. So all of your worship doesn't equal only one blessing from the blessings that Allah has given you, like the blessing of hearing, of sight. So don't be arrogant. Don't feel that you are better than others by worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. No, it is Allah who only guided you, who guided your heart and make you came now to the masjid. Allah is the only one who made you come now to the masjid to listen to khutbah, to benefit, to be rewarded. So you have to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to guide you. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us to the straight path. And put in your consideration that every act you are doing in this life, any act, you can turn it to an act of worship. Any act you do, you can make it an act of worship. By making your intention for Allah Azza wa Jal, by making a sincere intention. To give you an example, we eat and drink. But if you make your intention by eating and drinking to strengthen your body to worship Allah, so you eat and drink and you will be rewarded. So habits can be transformed into acts of worship by having good intention before doing any act. And also to give you an example, we all sleep. But if you make a good intention before you sleep, that you will sleep or you are going to sleep to rest and to get energy to worship Allah and to work to get provision and sustenance for your kids and for your family as Allah order you, subhanAllah, you sleep and you will be rewarded. Even if when you fulfill your desire or you become with your wife and you have good intention before doing something like that, you will be rewarded for that. As he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, في وضع أحدكم صدقة فقالوا يا رسول الله أيأتي أحدنا شهوته ويكون له أجر فقال أرأيتم لو وضعها في الحرام أكان عليه وزر قالوا نعم قال فكذلك لو وضعها في الحلال كان له أجر. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, in the sexual act you have with your wife, there is a kind of charity, there is a sadaqah. So the Sahaba asked him, O Messenger of Allah, we do that, we fulfill our desire, and then we will be rewarded. He said, yeah, صلى الله عليه وسلم. أرأيتم لو وضعها في الحرام أكان عليه وزر. What about if he did something like that, or did something forbidden like that, or make it in a forbidden way, will he be considered like a sinful person? He said, yeah, O Messenger of Allah. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَكَذَلِكَ لَوْ وَضَعَهَا فِي الْحَلَالِ كَانَ لَهُ أَجْرٌ. And the same thing, if he did it in a lawful way for his wife, inshallah, he will be rewarded. So everything, any act you do in this life, if you make a good intention before doing any act, you make it like an act of worship, and you will be rewarded for that. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر ذنوبنا وأن يصلح أحوالنا وأن يفرج همنا وأن يكشف كربنا وأن يقضي ديننا وأن يعافينا وأن يعفو عنا وأن يعفو عنا وأن يجعلنا من عباده الصالحين. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين المقربين. اللهم فرج عن المسلمين ما هم فيه من شقاء وعناء يا رب العالمين. اللهم رحمك بالمسلمين في فلسطين ورحمك بالمسلمين في بقاع الأرض جميعا يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لهم ناصرا ومعينا ومؤيدا يا رب العالمين. آمين آمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
اللهم صل الله اكبر اشهد ان لا اله الا الله اشهد ان محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاه حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاه قد قامت الصلاه الله اكبر الله اكبر لا اله الا الله
لا
اله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ففروا إلى الله إني لكم منه نذير مبين ولا تجعلوا مع الله إلها آخر إني لكم منه نذير مبين كذلك ما أتى الذين من قبلهم من رسول إلا قالوا ساحر أو مجنون أتواصوا به بل هم قوم طاغون فتول عنهم فما أنت بملوم وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين فإن للذين ظلموا ذنوبا مثل ذنوب أصحابهم فلا يستعجلون فويل للذين كفروا من يومهم الذي يوعدون سمع الله لمن حمده الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
There is a brother who asked us to meet Dua for him. He is ill and he asked us to meet Dua for him. So inshallah we are going to meet Dua for him. So we نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفيه وأن يعافيه وأن يعفو عنه وأن يذهب ضره وأن يذهب مسه وأن يعافيه مما أصابه من بلاء وعناء وأن يكشف عنه الشقاء وأن يكشف عن المسلمين أجمعين ما هم فيه يا رب العالمين. اللهم رب الناس أذهب الباس اشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما اشفه واشف جميع مرضى المسلمين وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على حبيبنا وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.